ASU launches Project Humanities this week, and here to tell us what the event is all about is Dr. Neal Lester, Dean of Humanities for ASU's College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Before we talk about what Project Humanities is supposed to do, what are the humanities? I got a feeling this is touching the elephant a little bit. Everyone's got a different idea.
Well, that's the million-dollar question. And it's interesting because one of the ways that we've tried to approach Project Humanities is not by defining it, but rather showing what humanities do or does. So it's bringing people together to recognize that there are more things that unite us than separate us. And it's all around ideas and the ways in which we try to make meaning of our existence.
So things like arts, literature, the classics, liberal arts in general, that's
yes.
All encompassing there?
Well, it's all encompassing, but the problem with that is when you start with definitions, mm-hmm. then definitions are by nature not static. And what's easier is to talk about what humanities does, the skills that you get from humanities. When you start talking about the arts, when you start talking about literature, the question becomes, well, how do you define literature? And how do you define the arts? So we say when you bring people together to recognize those human ties, we are doing humanities.
Interesting. Well, give us another example. That's a good example,
okay.
Right there. But give us an example. How do you live an ethical life? How do you
right.
share your experiences? Those
That's
sorts
right.
of things.
That's right. Well, what are the things that make us look at what it means to be human on this planet? And what that means exactly is there's nothing bigger than life. And so one of the ways that research in humanities and those who teach humanities and those who self-identify as humanists is that we try to analyze, we try to critique, we also try to understand and to ask questions. And by talking and listening, the idea is that we will connect and recognize that we do not exist as a single object on this planet, and that nothing is created for the sake of its creation, that on some level it needs to have some connection with that who, the person who created it, or the purpose of its creation.
So how do you connect, though, with folks who don't want to be connected? And there's a lot of them out there, trust me.
Well, part of what we try to do with Project Humanities is to say, this is about humanities every day and everyday humanities. So no one exists in a vacuum. And the way in which we make meaning is to define ourselves relative to other people. So we do humanities even when we don't acknowledge what it is, in the same way that people do things before we're able to name it. So humanities is actually the coming together and acknowledging those commonalities. We don't have to explain, for example, why we pray or why we write notes at times of great loss. At the Tucson tragedy, for example, nobody was told how to behave. People responded because there was something that went beyond those things that divide us. What we're trying to look at are those in-between spaces so that we don't have to look for a 9/11 to make us realize that we are more alike than we are different.
So why do I keep hearing that there's a chasm between humanities and science, between or a problem with humanities and politics? It seems
right.
like humanities always having to fight, having
it
to
is.
Defend
it
itself
is.
And figure out, you know, trying to convince people we're not bad.
Well, part of that is trying to educate and also trying to better understand what humanities are and to move away from this sense that we have to go to a dictionary definition in order to understand what it is. So by coming together and bringing people who are not necessarily identified as humanists, we talk about those things that we share. We talk about stories. We talk about empathy. We talk about language. We talk about traveling to other countries where you learn about the culture through learning the language. So it's not so academic, but it is academic. We have research that's around language that really impacts how we interact and how we make meaning of everyday experiences.
So with that, we have Project Humanities.
Yes.
All set to go here. What are we talking about?
Well, Project Humanities is a year old this February, and it's really an ASU university-wide initiative that does exactly what we've tried to do in talking about humanities generally, bring people across the campus, students, faculty, administrators, staff, together talking about an idea, thinking about an idea, talking, listening, and connecting, and recognizing that those experiences are just as important as jobs that we have.
Interesting. Last question before we let you go now. Humanities' place in society. I'm sure
yes.
this is kind of, again, will be talked about here at the Project Humanities. What is it?
Well, it's like air. It's like air. We don't know it's there until we start losing it.
Mm-hmm.
And when we start recognizing moments of loss, when we start recognizing good experiences that we have from reading a book or seeing a play or seeing a movie and wanting to talk to somebody about it, that becomes humanities in action.
Very good. Dr. Lester, it's good to have you here. Thank you for joining us. Good luck with Project Humanities.
Thank you very much.
And that is it for now. I'm Ted Simons. Thank you so much for joining us. You have a great evening.